I've recently noticed a trend on internet suggesting that taking or making notes is not the best utilization of our times. And serious students should stop making notes and focus on scientifically proven methods of active recall and spaced repetition if they want to study better. Although I absolutely agree that active recall and spaced repetition are the best methods to remember for long, but that doesn't remove the necessity of having a solid set of notes. So in this video, I will talk about notes and what's everything that is right and wrong about notes. So without further ado, let's get on with it. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Dr. Abbas Ali, a full-time orthopedic surgeon and a faculty of orthopedic who teaches orthopedics for under and postgraduates all over the country. I'm also a father of two boisterous young kids, and if you think those were the things that were already keeping me busy, I occasionally dabble into making YouTube videos for you. So if you like my content, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel to show some love. So let's come back to the original point of this video, making notes. So the first question is, why do we need notes? See, you may be a student learning on your own or attending classes that are either offline or online or watching video lectures, it doesn't matter. Having notes is an important part of your preparation. And this important exercise is being neglected by a lot of new generation students. And that's the reason I wanted to make this video, to re-emphasize its importance, especially in this era of ready-made notes and Xerox notes available in the market for killer discounts. See, let me ask you this question. What is the purpose of learning? Why do we need to learn? See, the whole purpose of learning, according to me, is to basically perform or output on either the exam or your job or generally in your life, so that eventually, if you do it right, you will win. Now, this requires a lot of understanding of concepts and memorization of facts. Now, where do you get these facts and concepts from? You can get it from books, class, or materials that you purchase for your academic curriculum. Now, as you keep on learning these facts and concepts, you will realize that the information is getting beyond the capacity of your brain, and that's when you start to forget them. And we all know that forgetting is expected. That's why we revise. How do we revise? There are two ways of revising. First is going back to the original source of information, the original books, the class, or the material that you have used to collect that concept or fact. Now, obviously, every time you decide to revise, you can't go back to the class because class is already done, and you can't go back and read the whole textbook yet again because it's enormous. It'll take a lot of time. That's why you need a place to keep all the information that you have collected and read from different sources in one place so that you can quickly go to it, revise, and come back. That's where your notes come into picture. The other advantage of making notes, which I have noticed it personally, is that whenever I'm in class trying to listen to the lecturer, I usually wander around in my thoughts because I just don't have that kind of attention span. So making notes keeps me on track and keeps me in focus with the class so that I don't get distracted and start daydreaming about owning a Lamborghini someday. And also, side note, my thoughts are kind of crazy, so I don't want to be with them alone. I just want to pay attention to the lecturer. But the third advantage of having notes handy is that it gives you the structure of the content that you're reading or revising. It gives you a bigger picture of where things are sorted accordingly. Otherwise, usually there will be an ocean of information and you'll be lost and confused searching for that bit of information you think that you have read somewhere. One example I would like to give you about making notes is, for example, this video. As I've been planning to make this video, I charted out the structure of the script that I would say out to you so that I don't get distracted and go on in a tangent talking about something that is irrelevant. So what are the types of notes? There are two important types of notes, self-made notes or pre-made notes. Obviously, you understand, right? Self-made notes matlab aapne khud hi banaye hain, and pre-made note means somebody else has made it for you. Now, the self-made notes can be prepared either by writing with your own hand on a piece of paper, garibi, or writing with your Apple Pencil on a brand new expensive iPad, bade log, or typing it out on computers. Now, in my so many years of learning and teaching, I've hardly noticed a few people type. Not a lot of people do it in India, but the trend is picking up. They start typing in class. So these are the various methods of making your own notes. Writing with your own hand on paper, on an iPad, or typing it out on a laptop. Now, there is one more method which was used by Aamir Khan, and it involves using a black marker pen and a lot of places on your body. I don't think that's a very good idea. Now, there is enough evidence suggesting that handmade or self-written notes are much better than typing out notes. So let's not talk about that. So let's talk about the self-made handwritten notes. So these self-made handwritten notes can be prepared from standard textbooks or in the class. Let's talk about from standard textbook first. See, when you read information from a standard textbook, there must be a lot of information, a lot of fluff. You process that information and then you write down the notes. See, by doing this, what happens is the first comprehension or the first pass of information has already happened. happened in your brain, you have processed it, analyzed it, and now you're writing the key points that you need to remember from that fluff of information from the book. This is why making notes is important. You're processing the information as you're consuming it. You're not writing down everything and making a second textbook. Now, in class, you make notes by listening to the lecturer or watching his slideshow. And now here again, you listen to him, you consume the information, process it in your brain, and then put it down on the piece of paper, thereby giving you the first advantage of analyzing in the class itself. Now, this is fine if you're going in your lecture classes where the pace of the teacher is slow. But in coaching classes, usually the pace of the lecture is a little fast because he expects you to understand a few fundamentals. Now, in that case, you don't have a lot of time to process the information and then write it down on the notes. So what happens is you end up missing out on a lot of important information. So what you can do in that situation is write down everything verbatim, go back home, review it and reanalyze it and restructure it, or you can attend classes that give you partially pre-written notes so that you don't end up wasting a lot of time in class. So this is what I do in my class. I usually have partially pre-written notes ready, and the students in my class write down the information that is not there, thereby giving them ample time to focus on what I teach them rather than just writing down the notes. Now, if you have to attend a class where the lecturer is fast and you do not have partially pre-written notes, this is what I suggest you do. Go to the class prepared, at least partially prepared. That way, whenever the teacher says something or uses a term, it won't sound new or foreign to you. You will be able to write it down because you've already come prepared for it. I know that cannot be the usual case, but this is the best you can do. Now, before we talk about pre-made notes, I would like to thank Enveda for sponsoring this video. As we all know, omega-3 fatty acids have multiple health benefits, including reduction in heart diseases, help in brain development, and reducing the discomfort in joint diseases. Omega-3 fatty acids have a significant role in health and longevity of human life. They're an important dietary supplement in maintaining good health. They help our heart in functioning better and help reduce the chances of heart diseases. Also, they have been found to reduce anxiety and depression with proper medication and therapy. Now you'd ask me, sir, what's so special about Enveda omega-3 fatty acid supplements? First of all, it's manufactured in a GMP approved facility and it's processed to remove all kinds of heavy metals, especially mercury. Remember, a balanced diet with healthy food, necessary supplements, and a little bit of exercise every day is irreplaceable for great physical and mental health, especially for students. If you want to try this, the link is in the description. Of course, consult your healthcare provider before making any kind of medical decision. Now back to talking about notes. Now the second type of notes are the pre-made notes that are readily available in the market now. Now although I don't personally love them, there are few indications for their use. Number one, you can use it when you do not have time. Suppose you're in internship and you have just a few months remaining for the exam, that's a good time for you to use it. But even then, I want you to make those pre-made or ready-made notes your own, by annotating them or adding information to them as you go about reading and learning new information. By doing so, you will make it your own and it will be easy for you to remember it on your exam. And also one very important thing, don't trust everything that is written on the roads that are pre-written or pre-made, because that is the information that has been processed by another person or another student, and their processing capability or capacity might be different than you. So if you come across a doubt that you are thinking is not right that is written in the notes, please go back to the original source or ask your teacher, correct it, and then add it to that note. Okay? Now comes the question, what are the best type of notes? See, for me, the best kind of notes are the notes that are packed with precise information without any kind of fluff or unnecessary kachra. For example, there are many conditions that can present with pain, but there are certain conditions that can present with pain, particularly in the night. So that is the key finding of that condition, night pain. So that is what I want you to write in notes. That is what I want you to focus when writing the notes, that this condition has night pain, whereas other conditions may have pain in the day or night, doesn't matter. The point I'm trying to make is keep your notes black and white, absolutely black and white, especially for MCQ based exams where you only have to choose one option. Another thing that I feel the best kind of notes should have, that they should expect you to fumble and make a mistake, and the notes should show you how to avoid them. For example, if there is a condition that sounds similar to the condition that you're reading right now, it should be mentioned there for cross reference and easy recall. The usual example I give my students is about Codman's tumor and Codman's triangle. For example, if Codman's triangle is being discussed, I should write down Codman's tumor next to it so that I should remember that Codman's tumor is something different, although it sounds the same. So good notes help you identify the potential traps the examiner is going to set up for you. And as you keep learning more, you'll find similar sounds sounding stuff, and that is the stuff you keep on adding there in that note so that you should not make those mistakes on exam. Another important thing I look forward in good notes is having information tabulated. Putting information in tables makes it easy for you to segregate them, and if there are hard facts to memorize, you can easily identify them every time you open your notes to revise. And the last and the most important thing I feel good notes should have is marked important questions, and better yet, expected important questions. These are the parts whenever your teacher says ki beta ye important hai, ye exam mein pooch sakta hai, isko yaad rakhna hai, you mark Q around there or you mark a star. But then you will say, sir, the teacher says everything is important. Everything important hai to hai, kya karenge? Also, I've noticed a few people put 10 stars or like highlight it so many times to highlight that it's important. I think that's overkill. Don't do that. 1 or 2 stars is enough. Right. So these were the things I wanted you to do when you were making notes. Now, what are the things you should not do while making notes? If you're making notes from books, do not make them when doing your first reading. Because what will happen is when you're doing your first reading, everything looks and seems important and you will try to write down everything. Fir hoga kya is that you will have a clone of your textbook. So only when you come back and read the stuff again, you will realize what is important. And that's when you will pick up the important parts that you need to write down in your notes. In one of the old notes of Dr. Roman Saini, who was an AIM stopper and a founder of a major edtech company in India, he said that notes should be like parres. I like that. Parres are these papers or flyers or, you know, just loose papers. The information should be so specific and so brief that it should just be like on a piece of paper. I like that. Your notes should be parres, especially if you're making it from standard textbooks. Now, in classes, while making notes, don't try to write down everything that is shown on the slideshow, especially those tables and boxes, because most of the times those tables and boxes are taken from standard textbooks, and that is the stuff you can copy from your books later. The important tip for you guys is please don't highlight everything, especially after the first reading. You highlight stuff on your second review, because that's when you appreciate what is important and what is relevant. Otherwise, if you keep highlighting everything that you feel is important, you know what will happen? Your pages will turn out to be like the towels you use to wipe your face on Holi. Also, one final bonus tip about what you should not do with your notes is you should not keep it near your pets or animals. And especially in India, you should not keep your notes close to your friends just before the exams. So what are the takeaways here? Ideally, you should make your own notes written with your own hand. It helps you process the information, understand the stuff better, and helps you in revisions. Don't try to write down everything. Try to comprehend first and write down later. And if the teacher is too fast, just try to write down the key facts that he has mentioned. If you're trying to use pre-written or pre-made notes, make it your own by annotating the information and adding the information as you go on. Don't trust everything that is written on pre-written notes. If you've liked this video, please hit the thumbs up button and share this video with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. And if you want me to dig deeper on this topic and talk more about notes in terms of how to make them and what are the various techniques of taking notes, be sure to tell me in the comments and I'll try to make it next time. I can talk about how to make notes and what are the specific techniques and hacks to make them better. I guess that's it. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.